Hello everybody, welcome to the UT breakdown video for Ninja Gaiden Black. Now, before I begin, I just want to make sure that this video is only really going to apply to Ninja Gaiden Black, as I'm going to get, this is going to be fairly in-depth. Forewarning, this video is going to be pretty long, I'm assuming, because I have a list of stuff here that I want to go through, so I'm just going to go through this list and then we'll see where we are after that. Like the weapon breakdown videos, I'm going to include examples of the stuff I talk about if I can, and put that in a smaller window so you can see. But I wanted to start out with the UTs, as they are one of the most fundamental aspects of the combat system, and the game really doesn't give you a whole lot of information regarding the intricacies of the UT system, and there are a lot of them. It can look very simple on video when someone is just kind of chaining UTs over and over again, but for the most part, if they're doing that in the heat of battle, there is a lot going on that you are just not going to get an idea of unless it's actually explained, which is what I'm going to cover in this video. So this will be going up after a Q&A video, so there will be some stuff from that video that I'm hoping to do, as I want to get all that stuff consolidated. So just, you know, bear that in mind with regards to any questions you have on this video. You've probably already asked them by now, but if not, feel free to ask them again. So without further ado, let's get into the UT system. So right off the bat, the UTs are denoted in the moves list as Essence and Essence Max. So what this means is, in the example of the Plasma Saber, by the way, ignore the fact that it says level 4. That's just because you get that UT at level 4 and it alters. It will just say Essence and Essence Max. You don't have to have a level to have a UT. So it says Essence and then Essence Max, and it's got the Y button with the press above it, the arrow. So that means you have to hold down the Y button to actually get your UTs out. So the kind of, there is a noticeable like frame of when you will get a UT or not, but we're not going to get into that just yet. So all you want to really do is look out for when you start seeing those little lines absorb into the weapon. That is when you will get the ET or the UT state. And in the example of the Dragon Sword, you'll get Hey Straight Slash, which is the ET, but with no essence in it. So that's when you're going to start absorbing essence, basically. So bear that in mind. So these are all the same across all the weapons. It will always be Essence and Essence Max. The Spear Gun does not have a UT, unfortunately, which is unfortunate that I hit that one. So these are all the same. So what it means by Essence and Essence Max is one yellow orb will get you an ET, which is denoted as just an essence technique. And these will give you the 2,000 karma point bonus. So that's absorbing one essence, or charging up, until it is blue. The things that are coming off of Ryu, you can see these little lines coming off of him. That denotes what kind of ultimate technique you're going to do. Both are actually called ultimate techniques, but just throughout the game they've been referred to as ET and UT, just to separate them, it's easier. So one yellow orb will get you an ET. Two yellow orbs will get you a UT, which is the ultimate technique, which is the 5,000 point bonus. So in the case of the Dragon Sword, you will get the true Dragon Sword, you will get the launch into the multiple flying swallow, and the ET, you'll get the slash. So Essence Max just means you need two Essence Orbs, or one blue orb, or one red orb. A blue orb and a red orb will give you a UT instantly, so you don't need to charge up. If you are, for example, charging from this state, you will still need one yellow orb to absorb to get a UT instead of two. So it staggers in that aspect. So that's just a basic breakdown of what a UT is. For more information on the ultimate techniques themselves, you're best off referring to the weapon breakdowns. I'm not going to go over them too in-depth in this one, as it would just make the video even longer than it already is going to be. So now I want to get into the types of UT in the game. So this is kind of the tip of the iceberg in what I mean with regards to, you know, the game doesn't tell you much. If you go into a moves list and you look at your moves list, you have, Extinction Straight Slash, which is the ET, and you have Storm of the Heavenly Dragon, and that's it. There is no information about that move at all, except you need Essence and Essence Max. It doesn't even tell you that you need, you know, one yellow or two yellow, or one red and one blue. So you get very little information. But there's a lot of different types of UT. I've broken them down into seven different types, and these are kind of the most different that I can think of off the top of my head. So these are basically the different types of UT. So the first one is what I've always referred to as just cold charging a UT, which is when you charge a UT with no essence around you. So you just hold down Y, like this, and you wait for the UT to charge. That's the first type. I would also give that to any other weapon as well. I just happen to be using this one. The next one, and it's probably the most important one to master in the whole game, is the on landing UT. And that is when you jump and land and instantly press Y when you touch the ground, when you are in your landing frames. I talked about landing frames in the movement tutorial. So for example, doing this, an on landing jump, if you replace the on-landing jump with Y, you get an on-landing UT because you're in landing frames, and that's when you need to press Y to get your on-landing to come out. This works the same for, you know, on-landing anything. Like if you do forward Y into on-landing forward Y, just do it in your landing frames and it's exactly the same. But that timing is so important to get down. It's one of the most important combat mechanics in the entire game, is making use of your landing frames to do stuff like on-landing UTs. So that's the next one. The other one is going to be staggered. Now, this covers two different types of UT. But what I mean by staggered is when you manipulate essence to stagger your UT or ET. So, for example, if you were to kill an enemy, a man-sized enemy, with a heavy weapon UT, so Warhammer or Dabilaro, not the Dark Dragonblade, just the Warhammer or the Dabilaro. If you have nothing around you, in the time it takes that enemy to go through the animation, die, and his first yellow orb come out, you will always be able to charge an ET. So, just I'm going to showcase this without footage to begin with. So, let's say you do the Dabilaro ET or UT, it doesn't matter. It hits them, they're now in their death animation, you charge again, ET, your essence will come out now, you'll absorb it to get a UT, and then you can keep chaining this over and over again. So, if you have one enemy coming at you at one time, you can keep doing this. This is important on lower difficulty karma runs where you have man-sized enemy fiend challenges. You can stagger UTs with this really, really well, and it's a really good thing to do. The other meaning of this is simply just staggering the essence to get a UT. So let's say, for example, you have one essence out, and this is going to combine staggered and charging. So you have one essence out and you do an on landing, you absorb your first essence, but you charge up to the second level and you get your ultimate technique. So that's what I mean by staggered. The next one is going to be chained. Chained is really, really straightforward. All that really means is that you are killing enemies, you are killing enough enemies and staggering your essence enough to where you can chain UTs. So let's say, for example, you kill two enemies at once and you get two yellow essences. So those two first yellow essences are going to give you enough for a UT. And then on that second UT, you happen to kill three enemies. So you use two of those orbs to do another UT, but at the end you have one left, and then you can chain an ET, and so on and so forth. It's more of a case in fiend challenges where you are going to want to be able to do, you know, just kind of jump, roll jump, on landing UT, roll jump, on landing UT over and over again. That's where you're going to get into chaining UTs. I'll talk about that more in the staggering essence video that I'll be doing, but that's not as important with regards to UTs, so refer to that in the future. The next one is going to be an essence dragging UT. This is more often done on karma runs, but I do feel people underestimate how useful it is on just regular runs. There's a lot of instances in the game where there might be a rat or a crow or just one enemy that you can kill. And what you do is you leave his essence out and then you go into the next fight, and you open up that fight with an on-landing UT and you drag the essence. And that is why the on-landing UT is so important, because when you land, you'll absorb all the essence straight away and you can instantly do your UT. So that's the next type, is just essence dragging. Essence stays in a UT-able state for about 9 to 10 seconds. I don't know the exact amount of time, as it's almost impossible to tell. But from what I can tell, it is about 9 to 10 seconds. And by UT-able state, I mean that you can absorb it for a UT. The essence does have a specific number of frames that you can be absorbed for. You might have seen it in other videos, but sometimes you might see a UT and it looks like it charges three times. What happens there is that you try to drag the essence, and in the time it takes the essence to move from where it is to where you are, just that few frames, if that goes over its allotted time to be in an absorbing state, it will actually disappear. You'll still get the kind of explosion. You'll still get this right here, but you don't actually have a UT. That is hard to replicate, so I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that on a video, but I will try and get it to show it. But it's very rare, but it's something that can happen, and it's something to be aware of when you're dragging essence. You know, make sure you know you can drag it as far as you want to drag it. So, the next type is going to be weapon swap UTs. So what I mean by this is when you... This is usually done from a roll jump, and it combines on landing, but for the sake of just the category, I'll keep it simple. It's basically when you kill an enemy and then you move away and do a UT with a different weapon. So let's say, for example, you kill somebody with the Warhammer. It's a good weapon to showcase this with. So you kill somebody with the Warhammer ET like this. You hit them, they go flying away, and in the time it takes them to die, you want to do another UT. So you either swap over, wait for it to come out, and then do another UT. Or, one of the most common applications of this is windpathing an enemy to stun him and swapping in that time frame. I'll put an example up of this so you can see. This is probably the hardest one, as you want to, you either roll jump and then do your windpath, and then in this time it takes you to do the wind run and land, you swap. So let's say, for example, you roll jump, go into the item screen, select a different weapon, come out, and then on landing UT. That's the basic application of this type of UT. It's one of the harder ones to do. You really don't have a lot of time once you come out of that item screen to get your on landing input, and you need to be very familiar with the time to get that consistent. If you do it too early, you're going to get this. You'll get that. You'll just get an on landing. You'll get an in-air move, and if you do it, and if you do it too late, the spear gun doesn't have one. If you do it too late, you'll get something like this. So you really want to be familiar with the time so you can come out of it and still get your on landing. That is one of the most dangerous combinations of the UT types, is because if you have a UT, say if you have the level 1 Lunar out for whatever reason, but you want to do a Vigorian Flail UT, you can wind run, wind path, swap to the flails, and come out of that in an on landing UT. It's incredibly powerful. So the final type of UT is going to be a buffered UT. So what I mean by buffered is, in a lot of the moves of, in a lot of the other videos, sorry, I've talked about buffering in moves. So a good example of this is the Gleaming Blade. So you can buffer in Gleaming Blades in the recovery of another one, and as you can see, Ryu doesn't do anything there except do a Gleaming Blade. He doesn't move, he doesn't like take a step. I'm just buffering in that rotate Y with the recovery of the move. You can also do this in other moves and other UTs. For example, the most important application of it is heavy weapon UTs. When you release the heavy weapon UTs, it applies to ETs as well. If you just leave the controller alone and don't do anything, Ryu is completely invincible until he puts that weapon back on his back. And this is your buffering time. So it lands, Ryu puts the weapon back on, now he's vulnerable again. This is what makes chaining UTs on Ghostfish possible. Because when you land and that UT comes out, the Ghostfish are then programmed to come after you. So they'll come after you, but because you're in an invulnerable state, they can't hit you, so they go into their neutral state. They're not attacking you anymore. This is when you hold down Y again and absorb the essence, then UT them again, so you chain your iframes all the way. You can do this with any weapon. It just happens to work best with the Dabiru and Warhammer. You can do it with the True Dragon Swords ET, like this. If you leave the controller alone, Ryu is invulnerable until he regains his basic stance, which is this one right here. So you can do an ET. Whoops. Would help if I actually did one. You can do an ET, wait, do another one, loop it over and over again. Again, works with the Gleaming Blade too, works with the Lunar really well. It's a really, really good thing to use in the UT system, but none of what I just said is explained anywhere, which is why I wanted to get it in this video. So we're going to move on now and talk about uses and the utility of UTs. The first one is pretty obvious. It's the invulnerability frames they give you. You cannot take damage, you cannot be grabbed, you cannot be stunned. When you're doing a UT, you are 100% invincible. This has a number of applications. Mainly it keeps you invulnerable when you're fighting, so enemies can't hit you. But a couple of particular uses would be Alma's projectiles and Awakened Alma's projectiles. On Master Ninja, Awakened Alma throws anywhere from 10 to 12 fireballs at you. That attack in particular is probably the single hardest attack in the game to dodge 100% consistently. It's very, very difficult. So, if you have an Essence out, however, you can just on landing Gleaming Blade UT, and in the time that animation is gone, all those fireballs will go through you and you can dodge it. Piece of cake. It also applies to the helicopter's missiles in either the boss or the military destruction phase 4. Those missiles can be very hard to dodge consistently, so if you have a UT essence, just charge your UT, or if you have celerity, just charge up a UT with the Gleaming Blade or the Lunar, something that has a long animation cycle, and you'll just go right through them, and there's no need to there's no need to do anything. So it's a it makes dodging certain attacks very, very easy that are very hard to dodge when you don't have a UT. The next one is going to be its essence boost. For anyone that doesn't know, when you kill an enemy with an ET or a UT, it drastically increases the amount of essence they give you. The ET has a scale of a 3x multiplier, so if an enemy gives you 100, when killed with an ET, they're going to give you 300. And with a UT, which is the red, you know, ultimate technique, the essence maximum version, you get 7x the amount of essence. So if they're going to give you 100, they'll now give you 700. This is very important on higher difficulties when you're fighting the, you know, the higher tiered enemies. Stuff like cat fiends, they give you tons of essence when you kill them with UTs. I think it's in like 2000 and something. They give you loads and loads of essence. The clone Ryus give you by far the most essence in the game. It's kind of game breaking how much essence you get from UTs, and I'll get into that later on. But that's another main aspect of them that makes them so powerful. And the other thing is just how abusable they are. Once you really master every type of UT and you've got your movement down and you know the weapons, you have to know a lot to be able to do it, but once you really master UTs and how to use them, you're more or less invincible. If you want to play the game just doing nothing but UTs and really abusing the UT system, you absolutely can. They're by far the most broken thing in the game. They're more broken than ninpo, any other strategy you can think of, UF, anything. Ultimate techniques are absolutely broken, and mastering them is so important to, you know, becoming comfortable in every encounter. If you want an example of, if you want to kind of realize how good they are, try and play through the entire game or just a certain mission or something on the higher difficulty without UTing, and you'll be surprised how much more difficult it is when you don't have UTs to rely on. Because if you get into a tight spot, you can think, oh crap, I'll just do a UT, kill a bunch of enemies, and then I'll kill one by himself, and then I'll get a health orb, or I'll use the Kitetsu to get, you know, health back, or I'll buy some time and go into the item screen and use an elixir. You know, when you don't have that cushion of UTs, they're extremely, you realize how extremely good they are, you know, you realize how broken they are. So that kind of covers uses and utility. Now, what I'm going to talk about here is setups. This will just be completely different footage that I'm not going to talk over. I'll explain what they are first, and then I'll just play them out so you can see. What I mean by setups is that there's a few things in particular that you need to know regarding UTs. I'll cover as most of them as I can remember. I may forget some. As I said, you know, I'm an old man ninja. I can't remember everything. So if I miss any, feel free to let me know. But I'll go over the ones I can. So what I mean by setups is something that you can do that will guarantee you an ET or UT depending on the timing and the time it takes an enemy to dissolve. So a really common one that you'll see is when you have one essence out, you forward Y a man-sized enemy and then you do an on-landing charge. By the time he is back up, you've got that first essence and then you will get his second essence for a UT. Very popular on karma runs. It works the other way. Let's say, for example, you've staggered an essence orb and then you charge. You get your ET, the essence pops out, immediately get your UT, release it, you get your UT. That's probably the most common one you'll see, but there's some others that are a bit more intricate. So the first one is going to be the soldiers, and by soldier, commandos, sorry. The commandos are the guys that come with dynamo, and you get them in chapter 4 and 5. The guys that look like they're just wearing normal clothes with, you know, like some padding on. The white, black, and the commando guys, and you get the purple grenadiers on very under very hard, and then you get the armored ones in, I think they're like orange color or something like that. Is it orange? They're like a shitty orangey color, but they're the ones I'm talking about. So the one I want to talk about on these is when you do a wind run on them. Wind run is when you can either do this from a wind path. Wind path is when you press X and A together and Ryu will auto-target an enemy. This is why it's really good. Wind run is when you jump off their shoulders or their head, whichever you want to look at it. So when you do this, if you do this into an on-landing UT, even without celerity, you have enough time to charge up an ET as long as you land in open ground. What I mean by open ground is Ryu has a set distance to travel when he does the wind run afterwards. So let's say you do a wind run right here. Ryu's going to land on this wall, and then you're going to have to do a on-landing charge from a wall cling. That time is eating into the time it takes that enemy to recover to come after you, so it needs to be a clean landing. You need to land in open space and get this charge, and then you can charge an ET, and then if you have staggered essence, you'll get a UT, and you can always UT him. Celerity just makes it a lot easier, and you don't have to have a clean landing, but you will always be able to do that if you windrun a commando in open space, you can always charge an ET every single time. Doesn't matter celerity or not, you always have time to do it. The next one is going to be heavy weapon setups. I talked about this briefly in one of the other ones, but again, without celerity, if you kill an enemy with the Warhammer ET or UT, you need the Debilero UT, by the way, because you want the they have a jumping animation almost when you kill them with a UT. Sometimes when you kill an enemy with an ET, they'll just have a knockback animation, and that's not quite enough time, especially if it hits them into a wall. The essence will come out quicker. But as long as you kill them in open space and they land, you can always charge an ET, and then their essence will come out and you'll get a UT. So that's a really that's the basis of setting up UTs with the heavy weapons. Again, celerity just makes all of these easier. You don't need celerity for these to actually work. The next one is going to be smoke bombs. This is obviously a pretty common one that you'd have seen on Karma runs. But you either have an essence out and you smoke bomb away to charge up a UT, or take an ET into a UT, or simply you just want to use it to make it easier. Sometimes you might get hit on your on landing. Use your smoke bomb to set up your UT. It's really straightforward. The next one I'm going to talk about is the Luna. So when you kill an enemy with the Luna, if you kill him with the UT and he goes into open space and he flies all the way back, you should have enough time to charge up an ET before his essence comes out, like this. Again, if you hit them into a wall, it's not going to count, and that's just going to alter your time. Celerity does make it a lot easier, but that's just something to bear in mind. Against the clones with the Luna out, if you're able to hit him out of the air with the in-air X and Windmill Shuriken him, you can always charge an on-landing ET. Again, celerity makes it a lot easier, but that's a really good way to guarantee an ET kill on a clone and get loads and loads of essence. There are some other ones with the Luna that are more intricate. It applies to zombies. This you'll have to get the timing down for. I can explain it. But as long as you kill an enemy on anything less than the fourth hit. So the Luna UT has 5 hits to it, as you can see. I'll just show that again. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's the 5 hits. As long as you kill them on anything less than the fourth, so up to 1 to 3 without celerity, you can charge up an ET. The zombie essence will now come out, and you can now get your UT without having to charge up to a UT. So that's really good for staggering essence on zombies. Speaking of zombies, while I remember, the Dragon Sword, when not at the true Dragon Sword, so when you just have the regular Dragon Sword UT, you do the regular Dragon Sword UT, and then you have enough time to roll jump away, on landing charge, you'll get to an ET, the essence will now come out, and you'll get to a UT. Really good for chaining essence on the zombies with the Dragon Sword if you ever need to. The final one's going to be flails and nunchucks. There's a really cool thing you can do with the ending string on this one. Because the ending move is so powerful, you can always flip that to the other side and redirect it, kill another enemy. Then the other enemy that you've already killed, his essence is already coming out. And then that other enemy you killed is now staggered because you killed him later. So you can roll jump away, get your ET, and either use that ET or save it and wait for that other essence to come out. But that's a really, really good setup with the flails. It works really good on man-sized enemies. It's also not too bad against pill bugs, but there's much better ways to kill pill bugs for UTs, so you'll just use those. So that pretty much covers all the setups I can think of off the top of my head. Oh, there's one more I thought of, actually. It's incendiary shurikens. There's two more I thought of, actually. I'm so glad I wrote these down. So what I mean by incendiary shurikens is you can do this just from a regular jump, but it's best done with a wind run, which is where you jump off their head. So you can jump off their head and then throw an incendiary in them, and the time it takes that incendiary to explode, you have enough time to charge up a full UT depending on what you hit. So Masakado, for example, you can charge up a full UT. Samurai, you should be able to charge up a full UT. The commandos, depending on how aggressive they are, sometimes they're less aggressive. Sometimes they get up and draw their gun. Sometimes they don't. That is just an element of randomness to them. But you can also set up a UT and an ET with that. That is best done with celerity because it drastically reduces the amount of time to set up a UT. The other one I thought of is a firewheel setup. So when enemies come at you when you got firewheels equipped, the man-sized enemies, I'd say anywhere from about 6 to 7 times out of 10, the firewheels will just knock them away from you constantly, and then you can charge your UT. I think it was Kyori that first showed that. I can't remember exactly. It was a long time ago, but I'm pretty sure it was Kyori that first showed that. So that's a really good way to set up a UT when you haven't got any essence or anything like that. So I think that's it. That's all I can think of right now off the top of my head. So yeah, if you guys think of any more, feel free to post them. Let me know. I probably have forgot some. I don't remember everything. But I'm going to cut the video now, and you'll see examples of everything I just talked about, and then I'll come back in to this video and then talk about the rest of the stuff regarding UTs. So I'll see you guys in a couple of minutes. Enjoy. Hey everybody, welcome back. So I hope those examples showcased what I talked about in a lot of depth, and you can see them, you can see those setups. So now I'm just going to talk about some the final two things regarding controlling and manipulation of your UT. And they are redirecting your UT and aiming your UT. I'm going to talk about redirecting first, as it's the easiest one. With your long UTs, like the nunchucks and the flails, the Kitetsu, the Dark Dragon Blade, and the Luna, that's mainly what it applies to. You can redirect Ryu's attack throughout the UT. It is best used on the Dark Dragon Blade UT because this UT is so powerful. But 1 to 2 hits of this UT will more or less kill any man-sized enemy in the game. So in the missions where you have the Dark Dragon Blade, namely Path of the Master Ninja 4, you can more or less kill an entire wave of enemies with this UT because it's so powerful. So Ryu will auto-target whoever he wants, and then you can use your joystick to redirect that UT to keep hitting everybody around you. And that's a really, really good use of the UT. It's also very useful with the regular Dragon Sword on a Karma Run. The regular Dragon Sword has a really good UT. It's got 7 hits, and again, the damage is evenly distributed. A very common thing you will see to set up UTs is you'll do the Dragon Sword UT, kill an enemy with up to the 6th hit of that, and then the 7th hit, the hit where Ryu does like an overhead slash down, which floors the enemy, That will then stagger the essence on the enemy you just killed, and then you'll forward Y him and go into on-landing UT with the essence that just came out. It's a very, very common thing to see on Karma runs with the Dragon Sword up to level 3. It's a very good use of that. The next one is going to be aiming your UT, and this is really important because Ryu is an idiot. Ryu always likes to target torches, save statues, boxes, fish, you know, invisible enemies that you can't see, a stone that's on the floor, anything but the, you know, the giant hulking beast that's trying to kill you with your UT, which is really annoying. So aiming your UT is really, really important. And how you aim your UT, it's really, really straightforward. When you're charging your UT, all you have to do is hold the joystick and pray, and hopefully Ryu will hit the enemy that you want him to hit. Unfortunately, it's not 100% consistent. It is what my only real gripe with the UT system is that I would prefer there to be no auto-targeting with the UT. I really would prefer it if you could just tell it where you want it to go. The same thing applies to ninpo. I'll talk about that in the ninpo video, but it's just an annoying quirk of the UT system. But aiming your UT is very important. For example, if you have an enemy that's almost dead and you have another enemy that's got full health, you're going to want to hit the enemy that's got full health with the UT, not the one. You don't want to waste it on one that's almost dead. It's also really important for certain encounters. Later in the game, especially on the high difficulties, the game loves to throw in random laser crab fiends in fights. If you have a UT, you know, locked and loaded, ready to go, you're going to want to hit that laser crab fiend with the UT, not the jobber enemies that it's got helping him, because that laser crab fiend is the more dangerous enemy. You want to hit them with it. It's really important in boss fights. When you have a boss on anything above normal, they have minions as help. You want to target the boss with your UT, not the crappy enemy that's trying to help him. You can take him out, no problem. The boss is the big threat. You want to hit him with the UT, not his help. So that pretty much covers UTs, I think. I already talked about iframe and manipulation. I definitely talked about that, because I have that written down here. The last thing I'll cover is celerity, just real quick. It just tells you that it decreases the time needed to charge ultimate techniques. It decreases it by 1 second. So it takes 1 second less to charge an ET, takes a second less to go from ET to UT, and it takes a second less from, you know, cold charge to ultimate technique, you know, the red one. The last thing I did want to talk about, actually, regarding your frame manipulation, is releasing the UT on the very frame it becomes active. This is something that will take a lot of practice to get consistently. It's probably the tightest timing in the entire game. And what I mean by that is, when you charge a UT, if you watch really carefully, I'll slow some of this down so you can hopefully see, but the camera zooms in ever so slightly just before that charge comes out. It's very, very hard to see without having played the game for a long time. But when that happens, that's actually when you've got your ET charged or your UT charged and ready to go. So if you get really good with the timing, you can release it before you even see that charge. You can see there, like that. That would have been an ET, and you'll see it when those little lines coming into the weapon, they disappear when this happens. This is very, very hard to do. That would have been another one. I'm probably going to miss it a few times. Yeah, I was too late there. That would have been too early. That was too early. That was too early. That was too late. That was too late. There we go. It's very, very hard to do that. It's something that you'll see players miss it all the time. I just missed God knows how many there, and I've played the game for more than most people have probably. But it's very important. I'll put footage up of that so you can see it. I'll show like an ET, and then you'll see the essence absorb, but you won't see the red or anything like that. So I'll put footage up of that so you can see. A good way to know when you've done that, obviously you'll get the UT out, but just watch your karma window. If it's the ET, but you don't take any damage, if you don't see the karma boost pop up, you haven't done it in time. You're either too late or you're too early. So that's one. That's the final thing to note about the UT system. It's by far the hardest, but it's very important, especially on a karma run. That can be the difference between making a time limit and not making it. So it is very important. So I think that covers the UTs. This was a short video, but as I said, there was a lot to cover in the UT system. It's so in depth, and it's kind of shocking that the game gives you so little information about the UT system. If you have any other questions that you didn't ask in the Q&A video, please put them down below. This is a very complicated system, and it is hard to just kind of remember it all off the top of my head, which is usually what I do for these. I don't have a script or anything. I just talk to myself for ages. So I hope it's helped you guys. I hope you can get a better understanding of the UT system now. It'll probably help you watching videos now. You'll actually be able to see this stuff. You know, you'll be able to notice, like, oh, that was a setup UT, or that was a soldier windrun setup or something like that. You'll probably be able to see more things now that you've had it laid out. So I hope this helped, and I'll see you guys in the next video, whichever one that'll be. Take care.